Ladies and gentlemen, Macattack here, and we are back in the Rebel York Hangar to do yet another ship review in Star Citizen. Today we are doing one of the oldest ships that you can get in Star Citizen, the Aegis Stalker, or the Aegis Avenger Stalker. It's actually the Avenger Stalker. It's called the Avenger, but this is the Stalker model, because there are different models you can get for this. Main models being the Stalker, which is the bounty hunter type unit, the Titan, which is the cargo unit, the Warlock, which is electronic warfare, and the Renegade, which was done for sort of a competition they did a while ago. I don't really know much about the Renegade, though. So, the main thing about the Stalker, the Avenger, other than the fact that it looks like a space shuttle gone rogue, is this. I mean, this is the first thing I noticed. This is the first thing that I know about this thing, is it has this honking huge cannon at the front, the nice little Gatling gun there. This thing does a lot of damage on it. This is where you're going to do most of your damage on it. Actually, the other guns on here, this might just be because it's Stalker, are the super Sucker Punch Distortion Cannons, which, as we know, are meant to disable your ship, not destroy it. You could probably upgrade those, but at the moment, they're kind of a little... I mean, they'll have their use once they're activated, but at the moment, they're just kind of not the greatest for destroying stuff, a little slow and such. But this thing does most your damage. Now going on, we have a Type 1-2 there. We have two different missiles on each wing, which does its job. Now this is supposed to be one of the older crafts, which have been remodeled. They were originally meant for the police, and they kind of get remodeled by civilians for different kinds of uses. Because of that, it's a little bit less of a design, but you can get away with that because it's older. This is supposed to be a very aging ship. A lot of Aegis's... Ironically, Aegis's ships are supposed to be aging. There you go, there's a nice little tongue twister for you. Because of that, they kind of look like the old normal Terra type of ships and planes and jets and whatnot. Let's go inside to show you what's like inside. It's a little claustrophobic inside. Nice little, I think this is actually a wider door than the Drake Cutlass had, actually. But as you can see, it's very low roof. These are the nice little containment fields. I guess you could keep your friends in there. I don't know. This is going to be good for if you're a bounty hunter. I don't really plan to go bounty hunting, but you never know when it's going to be useful, right? Never know when there's going to be a very annoying person you just want to hold for next 20 years. Now, to get into the cockpit, this is very awkward. You have to go through this very little sort of crouching type area, which apparently I can't crouch right now. There we go. This little crouching area, which I totally failed at. Can I go inside this? Again, we've been having a few issues with things today. Okay, we're having a few issues today. Let's go inside. There we go. Now it worked. So you're kind of stuck in this little tiny cubby crawl space, and this is how you get to the pilot seat. I don't actually know what this is supposed to be for. You got your bed, it's, I'm guessing, escape pod there. I don't know what this side's supposed to leave for. Maybe you can store some stuff in there. But we go inside the pilot seat. Kind of nice little, kind of reminds me of a lot of people's computer seats, actually. Crawl your way in. And this just feels like an old ship. Look at that old display, all scratched up and such. I mean, yes, it does have its annoyances, but I think it does add a lot to the feel of it. You got your old-style joysticks. Everything on this claims that it's been made ages ago, and I love that. I actually really love how it gives the feel. And you've got amazing visibility. There's no bars or anything there. It's just completely bubble looking around. This thing's got some pretty good shields on it. You got your state of thing there, you got your radar, you got your target. I mean, it's simple, but it gives you what you need to know, and it gives it pretty well. I mean, this is pretty much how you would be looking. So yeah, let's see how it flies, is the important question. Alright, Avenger Stalker flight test. Let's look around. I love how they make this cockpit look so old and scratched up, because it is an older ship. Going around outside. It actually is a pretty cool design. It looks kind of like looks like if the space shuttle's evil twin. Alright. Now then, let's go. Let's go and fight. And show them how big we are. There we go, there's our mark. Let's go after him. Now this thing's actually got some pretty good boost on. Let's see here. Okay, I'm gonna stop there. We got up to about 600 there, which is pretty good. I just didn't want to run into the giant pillar. Ooh, already? What? Vixen died already? Seriously? Also, why does Vixen sound like a guy? Alright. Come on. Almost up to him. And there we go. Okay, we can see we have the two different things for the sucker punch cannons and for the gun. The one thing I will say about the Gatling gun is that it... Oh, that was fast. This is a good time to take advantage of this. It does a lot of damage, but it takes a while to load up, which is kind of bad because it burns out pretty fast too. Okay. Oh, come on. But it does a lot of damage when you hit. Of course, the downside is that you also... Ooh! Warlord stole my kill. The downside is that you also have to keep refreshing the bullets on it pretty frequently, which you do get a decent number of bullets in this game for the for this version, but if you're out in the real world, I don't know how well that would work. Come on. See, you're basically guaranteed damage if you can get it for more than a second. There we go. Look at that. 80. Ooh-hoo. A warlord! Stop stealing my kills. Grab the bullets. Grab the bullets. Where'd the bullets go? Bullets, boogers. There we go. Keep them topped up because that'd be good. There we go. More again. Now then, let's not let Warlord steal all our kills. 690. Yeah, he's gone fast. Okay, turn around fast. Actually, that's a pretty good turnaround. As far as the other ones have gone, that's a pretty fast turnaround compared to the others. This one's got a good, decent thruster on it. It's actually very maneuverable, which I appreciate. Considering the age of this craft, it actually, like, I wouldn't say it's the most maneuverable one, but it has a good maneuverability to it, which is great for going through this kind of giant minefield around here. And, you know, with a giant open cockpit like that, it's a pretty good visibility as well, which I appreciate. I don't like that you can't... Well, I guess you can see the green thing up there for your... I don't know if it's glitched showing the white there all the time, whether I'm hurt or not, on the wingtips. But I think it's a little less intuitive than it should be. But it's nice to see it up there up top. And the target off to the right as well, which is good. I wish that my guns were a little more lined up, so I don't have to worry about hitting one or the other. Oh, there we go. Yes, I got that one. Ha, it was me. It was me, Warlord. See that? It was me. All right, on to the next one. Okay. Oh, this is actually good. Come on. How does Warlord get that kill? That barely even counts. He ran himself into an asteroid. Okay, on to the big one. Where are they? No, I might as well take him down fast. Come on. Fast and strong. Come on down. That didn't sound good. Yeah, I'm actually getting... Like, this is easy to fly. I mean, it's not one of my favorite ships, but it is very easy to fly. And I really appreciate that. I can get some pretty good maneuvers going on. One thing I will say about the shield animation is that it's really hard to see with it splashing in your face like that. Which is probably intentional, but oh well. Ooh, there we go, my nose has turned yellow. Okay, oh, wow, see, that's pretty good. Like, I'm doing some pretty nice maneuvers here, and it's pretty good. Well, and I ran into... I say that as I run into an asteroid. Good job, me. Good job. I just get too into it. Yeah, that doesn't sound good. Oh man, I'm starting to turn a little yellow here. Not good. I'm not sure how long I'm gonna hold up here. Chicken taken down though. Come on. Oh, that's not good. That would be a missile. Dodge that. Oh, that was not a dodge at all. Again, flares. I need to get flares on this thing. Oh. 11, 16. Come on, take it more. Oh, lost it. 63. And there we go. There, my gun is kicked out. See, if you use the gun too long, it will kick out, and then you have to recharge it. And then it's just kind of a pain once it gets overheated. That works. Come on. No? What? Oh, no, I'm being targeted. No. Oh. And that is red. I'm not doing well at dodging here. Oh, this guy is a pain in the... Probably shoot him now if I wanted to. Oh,
Come on, but yeah.
Come on. Go down. Please.
Yes, 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 yes. No, 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 not a good time for shooting me in the backside with a missile. And there we go. Okay, that's one man. My shields are not doing well right now. Okay, let's see what else we have. Oh, there's the guy we need to deal with. Send everything after him. One thing about this thing is it does carry a lot of missiles, and it's good.
Yes!
Okay, is there repair in there? Because I need a repair. There is a repair. Can I hit it? Can I hit it? Can I hit it? Come on. Oh, nope, nope, come on. Nope.
Yes!
Not fully repaired, but pretty good. I can get the bullets as well.
Yes!
Is there a missile? I need a missile. Can I not get the missile? Okay, you know what? Get back at it. Gladius. I guess this wave wasn't actually over. Okay. Oh, you're getting actually pretty... Warlord's doing well on this guy. I don't even need to do anything for that. Ooh. Okay, okay. Missiles and repairs. Okay, up, 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 up. No? No? Where'd it go? Okay, whatever. Ooh, missiles. Grab it, 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 grab it. Wait, before it's too late. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, I think that worked. I think that worked. I think I heard the click. Let's get this guy. Oh, one. We're doing pretty well in this. Oh, 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 oh. I find it's a little hard to aim properly because I find it has a bit of a bounce to it. It's a little hard to fine tune it, which is a little annoying. 23, 2, 6, 6. Ooh, there we go. Oh, Warlord. So that's the only kills. Okay. There's the next one. Nova Rider. 350. Oh, these are the fast ones. Let's see how we go up against a fast one. Ballistics, that's good. That's more. Okay, fuel's full. I wasn't aiming for that anyways. Come on. Come on. That's a little far away, but oh well. Oh, nope, that's not gonna work. Just wasting balls at this point. Oh, he's close to the edge. Okay, okay, pull around, pull around, pull around. Stop, 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 stop. Oh, that was close. I didn't realize how close to the edge he was there. Okay, aren't you a risky little? This guy has got to go down then. Oh, that's one way to do it, I guess. Well, that's just that, though. I find that the biggest problem here is while your guns do a lot of damage, they overheat way too quickly, and of course, you know, trying to keep those bullets filled up. Because, let's admit it, we don't have giant floating yellow bullet things in real life. Unfortunately. I'm dodging. But the maneuverability on this thing is great. I'm loving the ability to dodge all these things. And I am doing a little bit of fancy stick work here. I don't think I'd be able to do this on a mouse keyboard, but still, it's pretty good. Come on, come on. Overall, I think that this is a very easy to handle ship. You know what? I'm going to leave it off here. I'm going to continue keeping this going as long as I can. But I'm going to end off my review here. This has been the Avenger Stalker. And I really do like this ship. You know, I don't think it's my favorite ship, but I think it's a ship that you kind of turn to in need of trouble. It's good maneuverability. It's... Ooh, nice missile launch there. good maneuverability, it's got a very powerful weapon, it's old but it's a classic. It's got some good flexibility what you can do with it, and I think it's actually a pretty good one. That's it for me. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys like this ship or have one you want to hear about, leave a comment down below, like and subscribe, tell the world about this game, and most importantly, keep on flying.
Arr. Not.
Eventually.